Praise God, children, and I hope you have been well. I have missed you for 4 whole Sundays, and I'm happy to be here. And guess what? We are in a brand new month, the month of May, and God has been faithful, and He has kept us through the last months, and we are here once again. But before we go into our class, let us humble ourselves and pray. All of you whose eyes are still open, all of you who are still looking at me, please humble yourselves and let's pray. Almighty and Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of a new month. We also thank you for the gift of a new lesson, Lord God. We thank you for Mommy and Daddy. We thank you for the church. We thank you for our pastors. And I pray that each and every child that is listening in today will be able to learn something as we start on a new class. In your precious name we pray. Amen, amen, amen. So how have you been? I'd like you to turn to the person you're seated next to and tell them how you have been. Remember during Sunday school how we would have testimony time? I would like you to turn and tell someone what God has done for you. As for me, your teacher, I have been sick, but God has healed me. And so I am grateful today. And I hope that each and every one of you has something that you're thankful for and that we can praise God for today. Today we are only going to be singing one song and it will be a new song. So Uncle Eno will make sure that there are words down for you to sing along with me. And we'll sing this song at the beginning and at the end, okay? So I'd like you to stand up and get up on your feet. And I'm going to sing the first part with Teacher Joy. And then you will follow as we prompt you, okay? So Uncle Jack, and the song is called I Will Build My Church, okay? Children can catch up with us. Pastor Joy, and I hope that you have learned one or two things from that song, okay? That song was basically saying, I will build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail, and all the powers in the heaven above and all the powers on the earth below shall acknowledge that Jesus is Lord. And so at this point, we are going to be going into our class, into our lesson. And I am going to ask that you get your notebook and your pen, for those of you who can read and write. And also get your Bibles so that we can get ready for class. I hope you remember what we studied last Sunday. Does anyone remember what we studied last Sunday? Last Sunday, it was Teacher Joy who taught us. And I'd like you to turn to Mommy, or to Daddy, or to your sister, or your brother, or your auntie, or your uncle, or anyone near you, and tell them what you remember from Teacher Joy's class last Sunday. And I know you have finished now. Teacher Joy's lesson last Sunday was around the Great Commission. Remember? The Great Commission and ascension, and Jesus' ascension into heaven. And Teacher Joy told us that when Jesus went up into the clouds, he instructed his disciples and the people that were around not to leave Jerusalem until a helper came by. And the helper that Jesus was talking about is the Holy Spirit. Jesus left us the Holy Spirit to guide us. And so today we are starting on a new class. And this class is around the church, okay? We are going to be discussing the church in the month of May. And I know when we are singing, I'll build my church, some of you must have been asking, me, small me who is in the Eaglets class, me who is in the Doves class, me who is in the Oaks class, how am I going to build the church of God? I cannot even build a house for my little doll. And Teacher Isabella, you're saying I should build the church? Yes, the Bible says that we should build the church. And so this month we are going to be looking at the church, continuing from the Great Commission lesson from last Sunday. And so I'd like you to still turn again to the person who is near you. And I'd like you to answer this question. What is church? Okay? So very many of you, before the president locked up churches, on Sunday you would wake up and bathe and dress up in your best clothes, and when anyone would ask, where are you going? You'd be saying, I am going to church. I am going to Sunday school. So I'd like you to turn and tell the person near you what church is. When someone says church, what do you understand by the word church? Okay? And I know that many of you have given very many different answers about what you think church is. So usually when people talk about church, they talk about church in about three different ways. The first way they talk about church is as a place, okay? So you might be telling Mommy, some of you I know have been disturbing Mommy and Daddy and saying, when are we going back to church? We haven't been to church in a long time. And so when you talk about church, you look at church as a place. When you look at the Church of Deliverance, Church Kololo, you look at it as a building in Kololo somewhere there near Kampala Parents. Where you go on Sunday? So the first way some people look at church is as a place where they go to find or to praise God. The second way that some people think church is or look at church is as a meeting itself, okay? And so some people will come and they'll say, after church, we will go for a party. So at times they make church look like it's a place where you go and just be there meeting people or doing very many things, okay? So that's the second definition that people might give when you ask, what is church? They might say, church is a place I go to meet people. And then there is the first category I talked about that will say that church is a place where I go to. Okay? It's a place where I go to. It's a building somewhere. And there are some people who, when you ask them, what is church? They will say, church are people, the people that I find in a certain building in Kololo. Okay? So, for example, we might be here and then we say, oh, Sunday school children have a party. Can the church please give Sunday school children money for a bouncing castle? And then when the church gives us money, we say, we thank the church for giving us money for a bouncing castle. So at times we might look at church as people. Okay? Now that you have answered what church is, I would like us to go to the book of Matthew. And let's read from Matthew chapter 16, verse 18. And Matthew chapter 16, verse 18 says, and so I tell you, Peter, this was Jesus telling Peter, and so I tell you, Peter, you are a rock, and on this rock foundation I will build my church, and not even death will be able to overcome it. Okay? And so Jesus was telling Peter, who was a person like you, that he was going to build his church on Peter the rock. Okay? And so, when we look at the Bible and what the Bible tells us church is, in Ephesians chapter 5, verse 27, and Uncle Eno, I know, has put the verse there so you can read along with him. It says, he did this to present her to himself as a glorious church without spot or wrinkle or blemish. So the Bible looks at church as a group of people who are coming together to God without wrinkle or blemish. Okay? Also, as time went on in the New Testament, people began to refer to church as a place where they met to glorify God. They looked at it as the Lord's house. The church, according to the Bible, refers to the people of God. So if you're a child and you say that you love God, if you have accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior, if you believe that Jesus died on the cross for you, the Bible says that you are a church. Are we together? Church is not the building that you go to at DC Kololo on Sundays. Church is not you coming to play in the field. Some of you leave your homes and you come and you play in the compound, play with cars, you know, touch them. You don't even go to Sunday school. But God is saying that you are the church. So even as you come here to DC Kololo and you play in the compound, the entire church of God is playing through you. Okay? When we are watching this service with God and you're playing, just know that the church, if you're not paying attention, know the church is not paying attention. Okay? So, God would like us as children and even we as teachers to respond to him when he says that he will build his church and the gates of hell shall not prevail. That if you and I are the church, if Peter was the church, then God is going to build the church through you and the gates of hell shall not prevail. Remember last Sunday when Teacher Joy said that when we go out, let us tell people about Jesus. Every time you go out and you're telling people about Jesus, you're being the church, okay? If you have already started going to school, and I know very many of you have started going to school, does your neighbor know that you're a Christian? Or your neighbor thinks that you're the worst child in the school because you're always beating your neighbor? Does your teacher know you're a Christian? When you behave, do you behave like a Christian in school? Do you share your break? Or are you always abusing people? Are you bullying children? when you go for football, are you kicking them? Because that is not how the church of God is supposed to behave. The church is people like you and me. And so the way we behave tells people about Jesus, okay? Wherever we go, we are the church. When you go to school, you're the church. When you go to the market, you're the church. When you go to the bouncing castle, you're the church. When you go to visit your neighbors, you have carried the entire church of God to your neighbor's home. When you go and see grandma, you're the church, okay? The church is not a building, okay? But also, when we go, when we do anything, we do it as the church of God. And when we do it as the church of God, there are very many things that happen. The Bible tells us that when the church met, chains were broken off prisoners. The Bible tells us when the church met, demons fled. When the church met, God came down. You know, His Holy Spirit came down. And during the Great Commission, when Jesus was ascending, He said, "Don't leave until I send you a helper." So where the church is, the helper is there. The Holy Spirit is there. And so as we conclude this lesson, and even as we go into the week, I would like you to remember that even if you're a child, even if you're 6 years old or 8 years old or 10 years old, you are the church. When you look into the mirror as you brush your teeth, you look at the church because you're the church, okay? And so in everything you do, with all the actions that you do, I hope you remember that you're an entire church walking. And when people interact with you, they see Jesus, they see God. Next Sunday, we will continue to talk about the church. And next Sunday, we will focus on the first church, the early church in the Bible. Because we must understand that church is not just the building. Church is not a place where you go and find Sunday school teachers. But church begins from us. And so we are going to recite our memory verse. And our memory verse comes from the book of Matthew, chapter 16, verse 18. And we will only read a part of it, the part that says, "I will build my church, and the gates of shall not prevail." Okay? Matthew chapter 16, verse 18. "I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail." Okay? And I hope that you have learned something today in this class. And as we finish, I'm going to ask Uncle Jack and Teacher Joy to come so that we can sing that song again and we don't forget it, and we can keep singing it through the week as we remember that we are the church of Christ. God bless you and have a beautiful, beautiful week. Okay? So remember Matthew chapter 16, verse 18. "I'll build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail." Okay? "I'll build my church.
I'll build my church,
and the gates of hell,
and the gates of hell
shall not prevail,
shall not prevail
against it.
I'll build my church.
I'll build my church,
and the gates of hell,
and the gates of hell
shall not prevail."
Jesus. into the week, and God bless your mommies and your daddies and everyone that you live with. Bye-bye, and see you next Sunday.